Okay, so let's talk about ideal and non-ideal solutions. We will discuss the differences one by one. Ideal solutions obey Raoult's law. Now, what is Raoult's law? So, for ideal solution, Raoult's law is followed, which states that partial pressure equals to vapor pressure into mole fraction. The vapor pressure is of the pure component and the mole fraction is the mole fraction of that component in the mixture. So, this is the Raoult's law which is followed for ideal solution, but non-ideal solution does not obey Raoult's law. They tend to deviate from Raoult's law. Non-ideal solution shows positive or negative deviation from Raoult's law. This positive or negative deviation comes or arises because of a term which is denoted by gamma and is known as the activity coefficient. The activity coefficient. This is responsible for the non-ideality, or the value of the activity coefficient gives us the non-ideality. Now the next point is, so the second point is, the solute-solute interactions for ideal solution will be equal to the solute-solvent interaction and the solvent-solvent interaction. This is my second point. Let me write it one here. So this was the second point, and for non-ideal solutions, these are not equal. That is, the solute-solute interaction, the solute-solute interactions may not be equal to the solvent-solvent, which further may not be equal to the solute-solvent interactions. So this was the second difference, which was on based on the category of molecular interactions. Molecular interaction. So this was the second difference. The third point is, the heat of solution for an ideal solution will be zero. So del H is zero, but for non-ideal solutions, this del H may be greater than zero or del H may be less than zero. So the solution forming process for an ideal solution will be zero. That is, it will be not exothermic, neither will be endothermic, but for non-ideal solutions, it may be exothermic or endothermic. That was the third point. Now, examples of nearly ideal solutions are benzene, toluene, and for non-ideal solutions, we have water in HCl and pyridine acetic acid. So these were the differences between ideal solution and non-ideal solutions. Thank you.